Hi, and welcome back to our e-telecast, God Has the Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. And we're on the theme, bring on the noise, bring on the joy. And our running scripture is Psalms 101, where it says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all you land. And we have been studying, and in our last time, come to understand that for us to come into the presence of the Most High God, we ought to come into His presence rejoicing. And we ought to come before Him being prepared to rejoice with every part of our being, our entire essence. We ought to be prepared to come before Him with every part of our being, our entire essence, and to make some noise. Now, for some of you who may have been or felt or feel inhibited, like, well, you know, I really can't do that. Well, I just want to encourage you to get into the Word and study the Word, because the Bible is real clear. It says, make some noise. And that when we talk about joy, and when we talk about being joyful, we're talking about celebrating. We're talking about gladness. We're talking about merriment. We're talking about worshiping God and with His joy swelling up inside of us. Ooh, Jesus. And then when a group of us get together, ooh, we ought to be making some noise. Yes, we come, you know, giving Him praise. Yes, we come singing our songs. Yes, and prayers also are part of worship. Yes, but make some noise. But, you know, we can make noise with our audible voice. We make noise when we celebrate God and worship God with our instruments. We make noise. But we come together in fellowship together. And some of us will lift our hands and say, hallelujah. Some of us will just begin to praise Him. Hallelujah. Some of us will begin to speak in tongues. Hallelujah. Some of us will break out in a shout and a dance. Hallelujah. And all of them are spoken about in His Word, telling us to come and make a joyful noise to God. And I found out that it says it several times in the book of Psalms. It says in Psalm 66:1. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Psalms 81:1. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Psalms 95:1. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And then Psalms 101. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. When you know that God has been good to you, good for you, and have been good to you, I mean, that's the least that we can do. You can go to the ballpark. You can watch your games. You can view your sports and make all the noise that you want to and don't have a problem doing it. But when it comes down to getting in the presence of the Lord, you want to point your finger at somebody because they are worshiping God, because they are praising God, because they are being rejoiceful in the Lord. Shame on you. Shame on you to point your fingers at anybody, because if you find yourself looking at someone else strange, you're not in the right place. You're not in the right place. Your focus should be on God, and you yourself should let go of all of your inhibitions and praise God. Make some noise. Be rejoiceful. In Psalm 32:11, it says, be glad in the Lord. You know, that's just not just some feeling. But be glad in the Lord and rejoice. It says, be glad in the Lord and rejoice, ye righteous, and shout for joy. Again, shout for joy, all you that are upright in heart. Be glad. Oh, Jesus. Rejoice and shout. Each one of those words to me does not give me an image of sitting with my hands folded and being very quiet. I'm not getting that picture there. I'm not getting that image. Rejoice means that I'm doing something. You know, when you're around a group of friends and you're all happy and you're celebrating, there's a noise in that factor. I mean, think about any kind of gathering you have, whether it's a family reunion or a party or a birthday celebration, any kind of celebration, there's noise to that factor. But why is it that when we come to God, we want to do something less? When this is what He desires, we were created to worship Him. We were created to worship Him, and we ought to go to His throne boldly rejoicing and declaring Him for who He is. Oh, how holy is He! Ah, He is who He is, the Lord God Almighty. There is no other God but Him. Go before Him rejoicing. Listen at this verse in Psalms 47 and 1. Oh, clap your hands. Uh-oh. Oh, clap your hands, all you people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Oh, got another problem. Clap your hands. I've heard people say this, and I've even experienced it myself. In some churches, they don't even want you to clap your hands. So it makes you wonder, are they not reading their Bible? Clap your hands, all you people, and shout to God. Again, make some noise with the voice of triumph. Now, how can I shout to God with the voice of triumph? Because it says, see, when I am in the presence of the Almighty, I am victorious. I can be triumphant. Because when I am with God, nothing can hurt me, nothing can harm me. I don't have no need. There is no lack. There's nothing that I would want for in my Father's presence. Hello out there. Bring on the noise. Bring on the joy. Know this. When the praises go up, you've heard it, the blessings come down. What it is that you got to learn to let go of. You got to let go of yourself. That's the first thing. Because self will block you of your own joy. You will rob yourself of your own joy. That's right. Because you're so worried about what other people think. Not about other people. It's about you and God. You and God alone. So if that's the first hurdle you got to get over is yourself. Then the second thing, you got to get over people. It doesn't matter if they understand or if they don't understand. Well, how else will they understand unless you set the example? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Mm-hmm. So bring on the noise. Bring on the joy. Until the next time, because I'm coming back. We're going to study some more. Ooh, I'm Pastor Amina. God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know. Because right now, you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.